Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Autocomplete control. Using the Autocomplete control, you can display the relevant suggestion list for the typed in text, just like how the Google helps its users. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's MAUI Autocomplete control to a MAUI project. I will also explain how to set a custom height and width to the control, customize placeholder text, change the filter type, and hide the clear button. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed on your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose MAUI app and name my project MAUI example. After that, I continue with the .NET 7 framework and click create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default application has been created, so let's check the MAUI application's default output by running it. Before that, I will choose an Android emulator from this list and select a Pixel 5 emulator to see the output in that emulator. The application starts to compile the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Look here, my application says "Hello world, welcome to MAUI app." Now, I will show you the steps to display Syncfusion MAUI autocomplete control. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI inputs NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion MAUI inputs package and install it in my project. Click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Okay, now let's initialize the MAUI autocomplete control. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, let's proceed to initialize the control. First, I open this main page.xaml file and remove the default content from the content page section. Inside this page, I import the Syncfusion MAUI inputs namespace and to the local XML namespace, map the default project namespace. And I include the MAUI autocomplete control. Next, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Core handler by making a call to the method configure Syncfusion Core. Okay, next I am going to populate the data for the autocomplete, and let me implement this with the MVVM pattern. First, create a folder called model and add a class named DataModel. Here, I make this class public and define the fields name and ID with appropriate data types. Next, let me assign values for these fields. To do that, first I create a folder called ViewModel and add a class named DataViewModel. Then, make this class public and define a bindable property called SocialMediaOfTypeDataModel class. And add a constructor for the class. Inside this constructor, to the social media property, I add the data objects with the fields name and ID. Once it is done, let me navigate to the main page.xaml file to bind the data to the autocomplete control. Now, I will add the binding context to the content page and access the data view model class here using this local XML namespace. Next, I assign the social media property to the item's source property and set the height request property to 50 and width request to 250 to render autocomplete control within the custom dimension. Then, define display member path and text member path properties with the value name to select an item from the suggestion list. Okay, everything is configured, so let me save the changes and run this application. Look here, when I type in some characters, you see the pop-up displaying the social media names in its suggestion list, relevant to my typed-in text. In this example, the data source contains a list of social media names, so let me define the property placeholder with the value, select a social media, which will be displayed in the autocomplete control as its description. Check now the short description, select a social media displayed as its placeholder text here. Next, let's proceed to customize the placeholder text and clear button icon color. To do that, I define the placeholder color and clear button icon color properties and set its value to red. See here, the placeholder text and clear button are shown in red color. Following this, I will proceed to show the autocomplete border in a different color. To do that, I add the stroke property and set its value to red. Now, the autocomplete border is shown in red color. By default, the starts with filter type is applied while filtering the data items in the autocomplete control. But you can also filter the list items based on contains filter type. To change the filter type, I define the text search mode property with the value contains. If I type some characters here, you can see the suggestion list showing social media names that contain my typed in characters in any position. By default, this clear button will be visible in the control. Suppose I want to hide the clear button, then set the is clear button visible property to false. See now, the clear button is hidden. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI autocomplete control to it. We have learned how to render the autocomplete control, set a custom height and width to the control, customize placeholder text, change the filter type, and hide the clear button. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.